Hi everybody, welcome back to the channel. I'm so happy you're here and I hope you are well. Today's video is all about my summer shoe collection. So I'm showing you every shoe that I wear this summer and some that I have not really been wearing, but in any case, it's all my summer shoes. Not to worry, this is not going to be a very long video because I really don't have that many to show you, but I'll show you what I have. And if you enjoy this type of content and would like to see more chic and modern fashion from me, please go ahead and subscribe to this channel before you leave today. And without further ado, let's jump into it. Okay, starting off my summer shoe collection with a shoe that I think is the most essential shoe in the summer, which at least from my closet it is, and that is the Espadrilles. So first up, we have these cute little strappy espadrilles from Zara that I just picked up on the sale recently. I've already been wearing them to death and they are great paired with pretty much anything. Cropped pants, shorts, skirts, anything. I mean, I just love espadrilles so much. These here I picked up at, I want to say TJ Maxx or Marshalls. I mean, they're just lucky brand, but they're so adorable little white ones. Next up, we have my favorite of the bunch, and these are the Melody Espadrilles from Sezane. Of course, I have to say my favorites are from Sezane because that is my most favorite brand. I love this crochet detail here. They are not open toe, they are fully closed, but they have the beautiful strappy tie up here at the ankle. And I absolutely love these. Of course, this neutral color goes with anything as well. And then I have these, which I have had for probably over 10 years from an old Barney's New York warehouse sale, very, very long time ago. And they just kind of stay in my closet and I pull them out from time to time. I think, in fact, I've sometimes gone seasons without wearing them and then I kind of rediscover them. So these are fun, fully black, also with a tie strap. They have this little gold threading detail here, which actually is kind of coming apart, so I can almost even pull this off because I think I would rather prefer them to be just fully black. So I might play around with them. So perhaps the next time you see these, they might look entirely different. And finally, for the espadrilles, I have these cute little flat espadrilles from Kate Spade. I've had these for a couple of years now, and I just love that they're flat and easy to wear and just throw them on. All right, next up are my flat sandals. So I don't have too many of these, but these are great for, of course, just throwing on and running around and running errands, that sort of thing. So I have these little cute little braided, these cute little braided sandals. I got them at like TJ Maxx, Marshalls, I'm not quite sure, but they're just really inexpensive, but they have this gorgeous detail. I love this braiding style. Next up are some fun Steve Madden sandals. These have this beautiful little rhinestone detail here on these clear straps across the front of the shoe, and they're a great little flat shoe. Love them for just running around and throwing on with pretty much anything. Continuing with the gorgeous braided detail, these are from Nautica. Again, just from TJ Maxx, Marshalls, nothing big, nothing expensive. I know when to spend a lot of money on a shoe and when not to, and for just simple sandals like this, I don't really want to spend too much because most often I'm wearing them to the pool or to the beach and getting them all scuffed up and messed up, so don't want to spend too much money there. And finally, for my sandals, I have these cute little studded kind of Valentino dupe little Nicole Miller sandals here with the little tie up here at the ankle, and I just love the studded detail. And I've said before, I cannot afford the Valentino, nor do I really think I want to spend that kind of money on these, but I do love these studs, and this is a great little dupe for them. I think Steve Madden does pretty much an identical version of these, and they're just really inexpensive, but I love that detail. So these are a little fun, more kind of a little bit of an elevated type of sandal. Okay, next up I have just a few pairs of flats, and these are kind of more of all season types of flats, at least here in Southern California. I can definitely get away with wearing these all year round. And these first ones here are from Tory Burch, and these are just a cute little quilted style with a nude color and black detail. And I think they're darling and easy to just throw on with anything. And these actually are also from Tory Burch. These are a little bit more of a loafer style, very, very preppy looking. They have these cute little tassels here at the end and beautiful green and white checkered. I kind of consider green as being a little bit of a neutral. Like, I feel like I can wear these with anything and get away with it. So they're a great kind of really preppy casual shoe. I just picked these up from Express and I was really drawn to them. I love this pointy toe here and I love this V here at the vamp, really nice and deep. I love the little heel on them and the strap against the back, just a really fun casual shoe. Next up are the strappy sandals, starting off with my favorite pair of the group, and these are from Sezane. And I have to tell you, I have never been a block heel kind of gal. I always find them to be a little stumpy and frumpy, and I've always gravitated to a slender, higher heel, but something about these just drew me to them, probably because the name of Sezane was slapped on them, and I really just am drawn to anything from Sezane, so I think that in itself made me fall in love with them. But as soon as I put them on, I did not want to take them off. I love this heel. I love this kind of detail with a little bit of gold grommets or studs or whatever you want to call them. The little ankle detail. I just think they are so French and so chic, and you know, I've been loving that aesthetic lately. And these are just gorgeous and definitely have opened my eyes to enjoying a block heel. The rest of these are a little bit more of a slender heel, not too high, not too low, but this first one, and I have a bunch of these from this company called Fourth and Reckless. I think they are a UK brand. In fact, I did order them from overseas and I bought like, I don't know, 4 or 5 pairs of them. They were so inexpensive and they came to me really fast. These are a really great kind of off-white little strappy shoe. I love how delicate and dainty they look, and they have a little ankle strap here. And I just love how these look. And these are also from Fourth and Reckless, and these also have a little strap here, a little single strap here, and they have a little bit of a square toe and also a square heel. And I love these because they are really very easy to walk in, because it is not a very sky-high heel, so really easy to just run around town in, believe it or not, it is. These are also from Fourth and Reckless. These are a little black strappy heel with a single strap here at the toe. They have a very rounded toe here, which I'm not that crazy about, because I think my toes are a little funny and they kind of stick out there, and it's not my total favorite, but I think they're really nice nonetheless. A great little strap here at the ankle, and the heel is definitely higher. I think they're a little bit better for a little bit more of a night out instead of a casual day shoe. Finally, also for more of a night out, these are from River Island, and I think I've had these for probably about 2 years now. But I absolutely love them. I love the details on them. I think they are a very well-made shoe for being River Island. They have a strap on the ankle here with a beautiful pearl and gold detail. The same type of buckle is at the front of the shoe there with a strap. And then I absolutely love this kind of very, very subtle snake detail of a nude, like two-toned nude color. And the heel is really beautiful as well. Very tall and thin, so definitely more of a night out type of shoe, but I love these and I think they're classic and can definitely last several more years, because I just don't think something like this would go out of style. Next up are my cowboy boots, and this is definitely a type of shoe that I never thought I would ever wear, because I'm definitely more of a city girl, but this kind of taps into my little bit of bohemian boho style aesthetic that I still have lingering inside of me. I know my aesthetic has definitely changed through the years, but that kind of just still sticks with me, and I do love wearing them from time to time. Starting off with these Mark Fisher little booties. These are just kind of white cowboy booties, and I picked these up at Poshmark. In fact, all three of these cowboy boots are from Poshmark. And I just love throwing these on. I love that they're ankle length, so they don't kind of cut off your leg at an odd point. And I just love that they're white. And then showing you the other two pairs of cowboy boots that I have, because I think these are pretty much authentic cowboy boots. And again, they are from Poshmark. They are very well worn. In fact, these are more worn than these, but I purchased them this way. I love that they are different heights, so these are a little bit shorter than these. And these definitely have this like really cool flame detail on the boot as well. And these are a little bit more subtle and a little bit more better condition, I guess you can say, but I do love wearing these with a short little dress. I just love that aesthetic, very boho. I love how it looks, and I'm trying to get away from that aesthetic, but just that side of me just still wants to peek through every once in a while. Okay, so what do you call these, ladies? Mules, slides? Are those interchangeable? Is it one or the other? I'm never quite sure, but these are my only pair of mules slash slides, and I do love them. These are a wonderful dupe for the Bottega Lido sandals, I think they're called, with this gorgeous quilting detail here. These are from Vince Camuto, or as my husband likes to call them, Vinny Camuto. Yeah, Vinny Camuto. But in any case, I do love these. I find them a little hard to walk in, but I'm getting used to them, and the heel is not too bad. It's nice and skinny there, and these are a really fun heel to just have this summer. I mean, I don't know if I'll be wearing them next summer. We'll see how strong that Bottega trend is going to last, but for now, I'm enjoying them, and yeah, Vinny Camuto. Next up are two pairs of strappy sandals also, but these have a tie-up detail, so I just kind of kept them a little separate. This first one here is also from 4th & Reckless that I bought on my little binge shopping of 4th & Reckless with the other shoes that I showed you just a little previously. But these have the great tie-up detail here that you can kind of keep at your ankle or tie up way up your calf, whichever way you prefer. I think it kind of cuts my leg off a little bit, so I tend to try to keep them a little bit closer to the ankle, but I do love that tie-up detail. And this is a really nice kind of taupey, neutral color, which I think is really nice, and it has definitely a bit of a heel there, so I kind of reserve these a little bit more for a night out. And then the other pair are from Express, so these are that nude color, and they have a little bit of a different detail here up in front. They have like three kind of little straps here knotted in the middle, so that is a very pretty detail against the toe. And they also have the strappy here on the ankle, which is again long enough to go all the way up your calf or just to keep it at your ankle, which is what I prefer to do. These have a lower heel than the other one, so I can get away with wearing these during the day because they're a little bit more on the casual side since they are not so tall. This is a really fun shoe for summer. I love this look. I think it's very sexy, elegant. Next up are my only pair of sneakers, and well, except for my workout sneakers, but these are Isabel Marant's little white sneakers with some red detail here. And I absolutely love these, but every time I put them on, I do feel like I'm very frumpy. So I don't know if that is just like a mindset that I have to get over, but I would love to wear these more, but I just don't because, yeah, I just feel like I'm just dressing down my entire outfit and in a way that I'm not crazy about. But you let me know, ladies, do you enjoy white sneakers? Do you wear them yourselves? I want to hear from you in the comments below. Let me know what you think of this type of style. Does it attribute to the effortlessly chic kind of vibe, or do you find that they look frumpy as well? So I really want to hear your thoughts on that. Let me know. Okay, this next group of shoes are also from my Barney's warehouse sale purchases that I've made 10, 12 years ago at the very least, and I've had them in my collection all this time. I used to wear them to death, and I really have not been wearing them all that much anymore. In fact, a lot of them are on my Poshmark page to try to sell them, but as I put them on, because I already filmed my little segments of trying on the shoes, I have kind of fallen in love with them again, so hopefully I can maybe find a way to wear them and enjoy them a little bit more. Starting off with these truly amazing lace-up, I don't know if you want to call them gladiator style or I don't know, but they are just absolutely stunning. I put them on and I just fell in love with them all over again. They are from that brand Jean Michel Casabat, which the black espadrilles are also from. So again, I don't know if this brand is around anymore, but it has this gorgeous kind of snakeskin taupe and ivory color throughout, and really gorgeous lace up here, but you get in by the zipper in the back, and they are just absolutely stunning. I love them. I love the way they hit me at the ankle at just kind of the right length. Like they don't look, they look really flattering and just so sexy. And yeah, I probably won't be getting rid of these, but hopefully I can find an opportunity to enjoy them again. Next up are these gorgeous suede, maybe they're not suede, maybe they're just microfiber, I'm not quite sure, but this gorgeous shoe from Lanvin Paris, and I absolutely love these, I adore these. This sky-high heel, of course, is really hard to walk in, and it makes the shoe a little bit on the painful side, so I kind of reserve these to wearing out in a very like really grand night out, but I do love these. It has a little peep toe here, which I kind of think is not really in style anymore. It's definitely not trendy anymore, so I'm not sure if that's, I'm sure it'll come back eventually, but these are just amazing shoes. I don't think I would get rid of these. They're not on the Poshmark sale. Next up are these Gladiator wedge shoes. And I thought the Gladiator style was kind of coming back in this season, but I didn't really see it too much. So I didn't get a chance to really wear these this summer, but I did wear them in a couple of my videos for some styling. So I did enjoy them a little bit, but they have a beautiful white and gold kind of threaded detail, and they have multiple straps here and a three across the ankle, so they are kind of a little bit of a nuisance to get in. Honestly, they do look quite dated when you look at them. I think they are very reminiscent of that Gladiator trend that was probably 10, 12, 15 years ago or something. Segerson Morrison is the brand, and they are a size 10. Pretty much all my shoes are size 10. That is the size that I wear. I absolutely love these. These are almost kind of, I would say, a little bit of a clog style shoe because they have a wooden heel, and they are this olivey satin kind of finish going on at the top here with a tie around the ankle and a little bit of an open toe there. Beautiful grommets here for a nice kind of very studded rock and roll feel to them. But I do love how these look. They're from Co-op Barney's New York. In any case, I do love them. I recently kind of rediscovered them in my closet and have been enjoying them. And this last pair in this group are my one and only Manolo Blahnik. This is the only pair from this brand that I have, and this is a navy, very nautical feeling type of strappy shoe. They have these two hooks here at the ankle and a very tall skinny heel, very tall and skinny, so it makes them a little bit tricky to walk in, which is probably why I don't reach for them very much, but I love this look. I love the color. I love everything about these. I just wish I had more opportunities to wear them. Well, ladies, I really hope you enjoyed my summer shoe collection. I really did have so much fun showing you these shoes and kind of reminiscing about some of them. So let me know what your favorite shoe was. I'd love to hear from you. And if you did enjoy this video, please remember to give it a big thumbs up because it really truly helps out my small channel so much more than you can even imagine. YouTube really likes to see that like button get hit, so please do that. And of course, if you want to see more fashion from me, please hit that subscribe button as well. I'd really love to see you visit my channel again very soon. Thank you again so much for watching, ladies. I have so much more in store for you, so I can't wait to see you again. And I'll talk to you and see you very soon. Bye.